Big Brother's made someone's dream come true this week. Tonight, you shatter someone else's. Welcome to eviction number two. Oh, my friends, if you want drama, you have come to the right place. On Wednesday, Liam won £100,000 and became an instant babe magnet, love god and complete stud muffin. Then, just 24 hours later, Ziggy finished with Chanel. It's true. They did. To be fair to Ziggy, he did take her to a quiet corner where only a few million people would be watching. It's very, very thoughtful of him. Tonight you can watch it all in its cringeworthy glory. But bear in mind, it might only be temporary. You know what these two are like. Kissing, not kissing, kissing. And as if that wasn't enough, now it's your turn to break someone's heart as well. To evict Carol, call 09011-212202, 09011-212202. To evict Jonathan, call 09011-212217, 09011-212217. Or to evict Shawnee, call 09011-212214. That's 09011-212214. At least 10 pence from each call will be donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother. Lines are going to close at 18 minutes past 9. But first, chapter 1 of yesterday's story. And there's a crack starting to appear in Ziggy and Chanel's relationship, and it's Billy-shaped.
Dear 23, 10:03 a.m. Most of the housemates are asleep in the bedroom. Carol and Ziggy are at the sofas. Last night, Jonathan, Shawnee and Carol chose to give the £100,000 prize fund to Liam. What the housemates don't know is that the winner of Big Brother will still receive their prize fund.
And it is a different game now. Because it's not about winning any money at the end of it.
Which will be beautiful.
And it'd be interesting to see who is suddenly Liam's best new friends, do you know what I mean?
Liam's, yeah, of course, yeah.
Were people sort of shocked when they saw us on screen, generally?
Yeah.
Saw what we had to do.
Yeah. Has my name ever come up once in that? No.
We're not allowed to talk about it. You'll get to find out.
Oh, sure, yeah. Okay. I'm quite wary of one of the new boys. I'm kind of with someone in here, and wherever I look, he's there.
Yeah, well, people have noticed that.
Yeah, constantly. Constantly.
And there was a bit of me that wanted to say something to him.
Mm.
Or to bring Chanel aside and say something to her, but I wanted to keep out of it, really. And so it made it much more difficult, because, you know, I'm very fond of Chanel.
Hello, Ziggy.
Good morning, how are you?
How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. I'd like to clear a couple of things in the air, because I know that there's a couple of things being talked about. I'm going to talk about the situation with Mr. Young Billy. This kid's playing a dangerous game because he's literally attached like chewing gum to all the girls. Wherever Chanel is, Billy's almost stuck to her arse. And I've noticed this many, many, many times in a little bit of a strange way. You know, when we've had a kiss and a cuddle, he's kind of looking over. Doesn't really freak me out. It's a little bit weird, you know. There's a weird side to it. I also thought, you're 26 years old. You don't really need this shit. You know, he's a young single guy, and he wants to do what he wants to do, and I respect that because there isn't much option for him now. Because unlucky for him, I came first. I feel very secure with Chanel. But if things change in the future, then it changes. You know, there's nothing you can do about that. I'm sure there's other girls out there who would be interested in having a relationship with me or something on the lines of that. I don't feel threatened by him. I'm not quite sure if he wants to try on with her or someone, or if he just wants to get makeup tips, or maybe even use their straighteners. I'm not fully sure just yet, but I will work it out.
...11:22 a.m. Most of the housemates are still in bed. Jonathan, Ziggy and Carol are in the garden.
May I just thank you for an immaculate toilet?
Yeah, oh, thanks.
I mean, immaculate.
Right, you have to shield me. You have to shield me. Shield me. Okay,
we'll just do something. No?
No. Just let me use CH.
No, fine, done.
Okay.
I don't know what you've done.
Nothing.
Well, I said someone. I'm not... I may be old, but I'm not stupid.
Very true there. There's nothing like that. It's just... I love this.
You speak in riddles as ever.
I know. I wish more people could understand sign language.
Do you sign language?
This is Big Brother. Could Carol come to the diary room?
Please, feel free.
Morning.
Carol?
Yes?
You have some writing material in the house.
I do.
Can you explain to Big Brother what you have been writing with it?
I wrote Speak to You Later, basically. There's a young man in pain. So I said I'd speak to him later. Someone has entered the house who is making a play for someone he's very fond of. And I'm quite aware of that, and he's quite in a bit of a state about it, really, although he doesn't show it. I'm going to have a word with somebody else, and I'll speak to him later.
1:17 p.m. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Don't know what to wear today, I'm confused.
I'm falling out with myself.
Why don't you go for the arse outlook? You haven't done that one yet.
You just go to your sleep.
What, are you going to come in my bed?
Yeah.
Come on, Chanel, yeah, you know that's wrong.
Shawnee, Jerry, Carol and Ziggy are in the living area.
I'm a person who needs a balance. I need the nice conversations. I need quiet and... You see, it's all about balance in my life. The duality of good and evil. Duality. What a wonderful word. Duality.
Yeah, so I'm going to call my first kid Duality.
Duality. I think you should call her Gonorrhea.
You should call her Cassandra.
I'll call my first daughter Midea.
Yeah.
See, it was a wonderful woman. She killed her two children.
Oh.
Because she wanted to take revenge on her husband. It's a myth. It's not real. But that just thing is such a funny.
There's nothing like Greek mythology to start your day.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Charlie and Brian are in the garden talking about Billy.
He's changed a little bit, I think, in the last few days. I'm not being horrible or anything. Mm. I thought he was quite right, quiet. He ain't. He's quite a troublemaker. He's always the first to want to shit stir something or stir it up a little bit, so then everyone will think it's not him, and then it all goes back on us because we look like the ones who've done the action.